Simon, Newcastle United in action tonight, but up against it because they're at Anfield.
Yeah.
Newcastle, we now hear, Alex Crook brought us the news yesterday. Kieran Trippier is top of their wanted list. And if they get him, he would automatically become the highest paid player in the squad.
Yeah.
Because they've got to do something to flash the cash to get him from Atletico Madrid to join them in the Northeast.
Yep.
I just wonder, Simon, if he goes there, this is a bit of a delicate balancing act, isn't it? What about the ones who are already there? In comes Trippier, earning a small fortune because the Saudis' money now comes into play here. Will that affect the dynamic amongst the squad?
They are second to bottom in the league, right? I think they would be best served shutting their mouths and playing for their Premier League futures rather than worrying about what incoming transfers are going to do to help them stay in the Premier League and retain their position as Premier League footballers.
But you know what players are like.
They may well be like
you
that.
You heard Trippier's
but it, they may well be like that, but that doesn't mean you have to tolerate it, because ultimately the reasons why you're having to replenish the playing squad is because they're not doing their jobs and they're the ones that are putting themselves in position of in the jeopardy of being championship players. Of course, for their careers, they will be better served by being Premier League footballers. There will always be the argument. There will always be an argument. If that player comes in and isn't very good, then the argument becomes even more voluminous, because people will say, hang on a second, he's come in, clearly he's on XYZ amount of dough and he's not lifted the standard for us. This is the lesser of all evils for Newcastle. That, you know, they need to build a position. People say it's an absolute tragedy if Newcastle get relegated. It's not a tragedy, it's funny. But they'll bounce back because they'll have the resource.
You would find it funny?
Slightly. But not for the long game, because I like Newcastle fans and I want them to be successful. I couldn't care less about the ownership model. I'd like them to have as little success as possible. But the fans, I'd like them
Why?
To be... Because I don't like it. I don't like the nature of it. I don't like what it represents. I don't believe that they are for the best interest of football and a whole raft of other things, right?
But going, so you'd laugh out loud if Newcastle go down?
For a moment. And I think a lot of people would do so too. Not at the Newcastle fans. They would be collateral damage. Right? And that's tragedy. But they'll bounce straight back because they've got so much money.
At the Saudis.
At the PR girl, at the whole raft of it, because I just think that you get what you get. But anyway, look, the breaking of the dressing room in terms of wages, they're going to do this anyway, because there's always going to be an element of the playing squad that was there is going to be potentially on a different regime and a different set of parameters than the new ownership model brings into play. I mean, the key components of the squad, the Callum Wilsons of the world, they're not going to have a problem with perhaps being able to renegotiate, but it will be some bloody sauce if these guys think they can rock up into anyone's office anytime soon and say, pick me for a pay rise. Sorry, you're second from bottom of the league.
Yeah, but if anybody knows players, you know players.
Sure, but it doesn't mean you have to tolerate it. It doesn't mean you have to tolerate players turning around to club owners and suggesting there should be more medical support during the COVID period, suggesting they should get pay rises during the COVID period, whilst everyone's looking around the world going, the only place that's not suffering economically is football. The bottom line is Newcastle players should be of the mind that any help that can keep us in the division will benefit me in the longer game and in the shorter game. And if any of them have got the audacity to walk into whoever is running the club, because we don't know who that is right now, his office, and say, it's my time for a pay rise, A, once the person who's running the club picks them floor up off the floor with laughter and recovers their poise, and B, they shouldn't want them at the club anyway.
So no, at the end of the day, Trippier and whoever else follows Kieran Trippier is in a win-win situation as long as they don't go down.
He's an England international, right? He's arguably a very, very good player. And so with that in mind, the best players get the best amount of money. And look at that Newcastle dressing room right now and say, there's a few of them that should get a pay cut, let alone pay rise.
Yeah, but all of a sudden, Simon, what you aren't getting, and you can correct me if I'm wrong, suddenly, overnight, two different wage structures operating within one club. The old guard are still there doing their bit.
But that's always the way in football clubs. You're always going to have a group of players that get paid more money, and you're always going to have the best players. The argument has to be, is the best players getting paid the money and performing as the best? If they come in and they don't perform, then of course people can have the right to perhaps be a little bit dissenting. But they've got no ground for being dissenting because they've been crap. Right, so how can they have the audacity? They will have the audacity because footballers seem to be completely unaware of what goes on around them besides what benefits them at times. But I think we're manufacturing that particular problem that may manifest itself.
I don't think so.
Because no, I think they'll get, I think they'll,
all they've got to offer is money.
Well, no, they've got the framework of a very
I mean,
big football
club. Howe and they've got Graham, my friend, and they've got...
Currently, you've got two phases. You've got Newcastle as they are now and Newcastle as they will be, as the image of them will become.
Yeah.
So people can get on board now. And what you look at today in a year's time will not be what you're looking at. If Newcastle stay in the Premier League, this group of players will be dismantled and disbanded.
Oh, they'll be gone.
Right. So yeah. They're almost an irrelevance.
Yeah. But you've the got biggest means of attracting top players is only money.
Yeah. And the image of what they will become. Because they will become something of significance. If money is the commodity that drives football, some people have to buy into the vision before the vision arrives. Newcastle have a fervent fan base that football club.
Yeah, I agree.
And ultimately, the money side of things, well, you know, with due respect to Manchester City, the reason why Man City have been able to attract so many players is because of the money side of things,
yeah.
Not because of their history. The history amounts to very little.
Yeah, having said that, though, Man City went in a relegation battle when they're trying to get some of these characters
in. That's true, but Newcastle are not going to be potentially buying Robinho. They're going to be buying other players that do the job for them at this stage. They need to do something at this stage. And even if they don't achieve it, I'll be gobsmacked if Newcastle stayed in the Championship for more than one season.
Oh, yeah.
Because they have the ability to be able to... All we're talking about is moments in time. And if Newcastle can wait 52 years, as Graham Souness talked about when he described them as not a proper football club the other day, which made me fall off my chair with laughter, then they can wait a little bit longer to perhaps take all the benefits of this ghastly regime that owns them.
So people like Trippier and others who will follow in January have got a decision to make. Do I accept a big bowl of money with the possibility is I'm going to be playing in the Championship?
But hold on, Jim, let's get that clear. What if you're Trippier, why would you be going to Newcastle anyway? Because you want to go there for a big bag of money because you're already at an elite football club. He doesn't need to go to the Vision of Newcastle because he's already at the La Liga winners.
Yeah.
So he's going
for
one thing.
But we know what he's
going to
do.
He's 31 years of
age. You know what he's
going
to do.
He's going for one thing.
Correct.
Right? You know, have paycheck, we'll play.
Yeah.
And you're going to get a bit of that. As long as you get the
right bit of
that. I
think you're going to get a lot of that.
Well, maybe you will, but as long as they achieve the ultimate... I mean, the irony of it would be if you get a load of that and still get relegated. That would be the ultimate irony, wouldn't it?
It's live and exclusive tonight on talkSPORT. It's Liverpool against Newcastle. Can you see anything other than another sizable defeat for Newcastle?
You can never... I mean, Liverpool, you know, are in such irresistible form that you would suspect that they're going to do to Newcastle what they've done to most teams in front of them.
Yeah.
But you never, ever know with football right now because there's such strange results that are coming out.
But you look at that current group at Newcastle, how are they going to change it?
They'll get their head handed to them.
Yeah.
They'll get their head handed to them tonight. And if they don't, then Liverpool got to look at themselves, haven't they?
Jim White and Simon Jordan. Monday to Thursday morning, 10 till 1. On AM, on DAB, via the TalkSport app and on your smart speaker. TalkSport.